the first video on constant power delivered load pull simulation, I gave an overview, then talked in detail about one-tone load pull simulations. In this video, I'll talk a little bit about two-tone load pull simulations. Why two-tone load pull rather than just relying on one-tone load pull simulation? With two-tone simulations, you get intermodulation distortion information, which is a more accurate measure of the amount of distortion a device is producing. Designers would like to know the performance of their design with real-world signals such as WCDMA, and in a subsequent video, I'll show a load pull with a WCDMA signal. As before, to run these two-tone load pull simulations, we select Design Guide, Load Pull. This brings up a dialog box, and we select Two-Tone Constant Power Delivered Load Pull Simulation. This copies a schematic and corresponding data display into your project directory. As with the one-tone load pull simulation setup, you have to specify the circular region inside the Smith chart over which the loads will be swept, but you also have to specify the center frequency of the two tones as well as their spacing. You need to specify the load at the harmonic frequencies as well as the source impedance at the harmonic frequencies and fundamental. You would replace this sample device with your own device that you're testing, but for demonstration purposes, we'll run a load pull on this device. To get a little better resolution in our load pull contours, I've increased the number of load points that we will simulate from 64 to 144. Because this load pull involves an optimization, we have to start it by clicking on the optimization icon. Here you can see the single optimizable variable, the power available from the source, being tuned up and down until the power delivered to the load goal is satisfied. The data display shows gain and gain compression contours, as well as contours of power added efficiency, intermodulation distortion, and bias current. The purple lines show how the input reflection coefficient varies as a function of the load reflection coefficient. These contours indicate that the point of minimum intermodulation distortion and minimum gain compression are about the same. The boxes to the left indicate that there's a clear trade-off between power added efficiency and gain compression. If we need the maximum power added efficiency, we may have to put up with quite a bit of gain compression, whereas if we're willing to tolerate a lower power added efficiency, then we can get higher gain and much, much less gain compression. This second video in a sequence on constant power delivered load pull simulation has shown how easy it is to run two-tone load pull simulations and include intermodulation distortion as one of the criteria in choosing the optimal load for your designs. Please view the subsequent videos on batch and WCDMA load pull simulations. Please visit our website for information about the latest.